Hey guys, welcome to Protocoders Point. Okay, so this is the sixth part of our Flutter tutorials for beginner. In this tutorial, we will learn about buttons and different kinds of button. So everyone know that what is a button? A button is something that helps a user to perform some action or a task. For example, he can submit a form by making use of button or many actions you can perform using a button. So in Flutter, there are different kinds of buttons available. So here I have created one list of buttons. So they are flat button, raised button, floating action button, icon button, inkwell button, and there are many more buttons. So in this tutorial, we will check out these 5 buttons in this video tutorial. So let's go to our Android Studio to build. Okay, so now we are in our Android Studio. Here I have created one Flutter project by some random name, that is Flutter app 11. Okay, so if you want to create a new Flutter project, just go over here, new Flutter project, and give a name to your project and just finish and your project will get ready. Okay, so here I have made use of material app to build this UI. Material app scaffold. A scaffold has the app bar and it has a body with a center widget. A center widget has a child, that is column widget. Okay, so I have made use of column widget because I can show you all the buttons by column wise. Okay, for that I am making use of column widget. So let's begin. First of all, I will show you this floating action button, floating button, sorry. Just enter float button. Okay, so it has various properties. Okay, so if you want to view all the properties of it, just keep a cursor in this widget. You can see all the properties of it. So you can see the text color can be changed, color we can give, and we can disable the color also, and many more thing we can perform. So if you want to see this source code of this button, just press control and just press on this widget. Okay, so it will open our Dart code, that is float button. So here there are various properties such as on pressed, on long press, and there are various properties that can be customized. Okay, so let's see it one by one. So if you want to give a text on a button, then you can make use of a property that is child, and inside child you can give a text widget. Here we can give a button as click me. Okay, so I will just restart the app so you can see the UI here. So as you can see, there is a button that has been created, but there is no border, no button. It is not looking as a button, but it is looking as a text. Okay, so the button is not clickable because this button accepts one parameter, that is on pressed. Okay, so you can just keep the cursor and you can import this property. Okay, so when the button is being pressed, so you can perform some action. So for now, I will just print this message on our console here. So as you saw, when I gave this method, the text got highlighted, means it become bold. So when I press this button, the action is being performed. You can see over here. So this function is getting executed. Okay. And you can also show an icon in place of this text. You can just remove this and give an icon if you want. Icon, icons dot, we can give it as add. Okay, so I will just run it now. Okay, so as you can see, an icon has been created. It will perform, it will be same as the previous button. So if you want to see the how much space the button is been taking, so you can go to here side, there is a flutter inspector. You can just press it and then debugging point paint, you can on it. So it will show you how much your app is getting, how much your space is been utilized by this widget. You can see there is some padding, default padding or margin given to this button. Okay, so now if you want to change the color of this button, you can make use of color property. Colors dot, we can give as red. Okay, so I will just off this borders. So you can see this is the button, the size that is been utilized by this flat button. Okay, so you can see there is no elevation, there is no shadow in this button. So it is a flat button, so it is named as a flat button. There is no dark shadow at the bottom of this button. So and one more thing I forgot, if you want to give a text, you can also change the text color of this. Okay, so button text can be changed in two methods. You can either use the property inside text. So here style, text style, color, colors dot white, you can give it. Okay, so this is the one method that you can use to give color to your button text. And there is one more property to give a text to your button. You can directly use it. Colors dot, we can give as gray. Okay, so you can see the button text got changed to gray. Okay, so this was the first button. So let's move to our second button, that is raised button. By default, the raised button has a rectangular shape. Okay, so even the flat button is rectangular, but you can see it is not so much customizable. Okay, so rise button, in flat button we cannot give any elevation or anything, and in rise button it comes with by default elevation, the shadow. So we will do that. For that, just enter rise button and we will give a child, we will give a text widget, and here we will give a text that is raised button. I will just run it. Okay, so as you can see, this is the raised button. It cannot be pressed because I have not made use of this on press method. Okay, so you can just on press. Okay, so in this on press you can perform various tasks. We will see this in the end of the tutorial. Okay, so if I restart this app now, You can see the button is been turned on. So now it is been clickable. So you can see, and you can also see a small elevation at the bottom of this button. Okay, so if you want to increase this elevation of this button, so you can just go over here. You can find the property. There are various properties, so you can see the elevation property is there. So if you want to change the elevation, you can just give it for now. I will give it as 25 so that you can see in this video. Say okay. So as you can see, there is the elevation dark shadow. It is not looking nice, but you can give it as 5, 10, 8 or something. The elevation will give a small animation effect. So you can see this when the button is been pressed. And there is one more property. That there are many various properties. The flash color dot white. So you can see this is. So I will just, I have give the white color now. So I will just run, restart the app. Okay, so you can see this white effect over this button, animation effect. And there are various properties, such as you can give the color to your button. Green. And we will give a text color. Restarting this. Okay, so green is not good. We will give it as white. Okay, so you can see when I have long press on this button, you can see a white effect. Okay, so this was the second button. Okay, so there is a third button, that is floating action button. Okay, so for that, what we will do here, after body tag, here floating action button. In this floating action button here we will provide a child property as the icon. An icon, we can give an icon that is, we can give this. Okay, so here we can set a background color. Color dot blue, foreground color. And I will just restart this app now. So you can see here one button will be displayed now. So this is the button. We have give background color as blue. So this button is not clickable because we have not used this onPressed method property. So you can just keep the cursor in this widget, and then you can add a required method. Okay, so as we add this method, so now we can press this button. So you can see, this effect, the button has been getting pressed. Okay, so here in all buttons there is one more feature, that is on long press. What should happen when the user long press on this button? So I will just give a print statement. Long press, restart it. Okay, so when I hold this button for a long time, you can see the long press method gets run. Okay, and the fourth button is icon button. This is simple icon. A clickable icon will be displayed. So I will give you an example. I will add this button after the raised button. After this button, okay. Icon button, icon, icon, icons dot, we can give volume, we can give it as up, volume up. We can give size to this icon. We can give a size as 50 something. Okay. We can give color black. And we can give a tooltip. Okay. So I will just tell you what it is. Increase by 5, and one more method, that is on press. Okay, so one more thing, if you don't want to include this on press, but you want to show this button and the button should be clickable, what you can do is just remove this on press. You can make it as null. Okay, so the button has been created, and if you want to give the action to this button, then you need to give this function. So as you can see, when I give this function, the button has been pressable, means you can perform event with this button. Okay, and then there is one more button, that is Inkwell button. It is a touch response button. It gives some animation effect when a user press on a button. So I will just give you. Okay, so for this we will make use of a container. Container, we will give a height of 100 so that you can see the effect of this button, and width we can give as 512 something. Okay, so inside this container we will set our button, that is Inkwell button. Child Inkwell. So here there is no properties. If you want to see the properties, there is no required properties such as on press or anything. Okay, so this don't have a on press method, means a property. Instead of that, it has a on tap method, on double tap, on long tap, on tap down, on cancel, and there are many various. Okay, so here we can give flash color, color dot green. We can give it as a green,
and highlight color we can give blue, and we will give a child icon. We can give a text over here. Okay, so I will just restart the app. Okay, so this is the inkwell printer. So there is no effect seen over here. So if you want to give an effect to this, here you can give on tap. Okay, so now I will just restart. So you can see when I press, it is giving the animation effect where a button has been pressed. So if I'm pressing over here, from that point up to the button, it is getting filled. So you can see the ripple. Okay, so these are the various customization that you can do with a button. So now I will just perform some action with this button. So I will just remove the code. Okay, so I will just remove the code. I don't need this floating action button. So here what I will do, I will give a variable. When it has been pressed, the variable should get incremented by 5 or something. Volume is equal to, I will give a initial state as 0. Okay, and here I will create one variable, means the text. Okay, so this is how you can print a variable on a screen, text and the variable. Okay, so I will just make use of icon button. I will give a icon size as 50. Icon dot. Icon dot volume up. Okay, and then when it is been pressed, it should increment by 5, and when it is a long press, so I don't think so long press method is there. Okay, so long press is not there, it's okay. So here when a button is been pressed, I will increment the volume variable by 5. So for that, volume is equal to volume plus 5. Okay, so I will just restart our app now. Okay, so this is the text and this is the button, icon button. When it has been pressed, the variable is getting reflected, incremented, and it is getting changed over here. 10, 15, 20, like this you can increment. Okay, so you can give one more button to decrement it, something like this. So here I can give minus 5 something, and I can give it as volume down icon. Restart the app. Okay, so this is incrementing, this is decrementing. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. Hope you got how to use a button in our Flutter app. Thanks for watching. Please do subscribe protocoders.point.